What would you think if you watched a forensic expert get on the witness stand and say five little words?
The DNA is a match.
The first thought that went through my mind? Got him. DNA is the gold standard of forensic evidence. Indisputable, right? I mean, we're talking about the stuff we send out to the lab to find out if we're 0.2% Italian, or in my neighbor's case, 2% Neanderthal. But in 2011, neuroscientist Idiel Dror and biologist Greg Hampikian teamed up to show that even DNA analysis can be vulnerable to our blind spots. Today, we're talking about one of the strongest biases out there, confirmation bias. Welcome to Outsmarting Human Minds. Imagine this. You're a forensic analyst on a criminal case.
Fingerprint check on panic check.
The prosecutors tell you they have testimony from one of the suspects.
I will give you immunity if you testify.
And he's revealed everyone else who was involved in the crime. The only snag? Unless you can place at least one of those other people at the scene, the judge is probably throwing this testimony out. So those are the stakes. You have the DNA mixture from the crime. That means it includes more than one person's DNA. And you have DNA from the prime suspects. So, is there a match? These are details from a real criminal case, and the real analysis team did find a match. Suspect 3 was there. Got him, right? Not exactly. Years later, Dror and Hampikian sent the same DNA to 17 new experts. Did they see Suspect 3's DNA in the mixture? 16 out of 17 experts said no. This is the kind of situation where I think it's fair to ask, what the heck happened? 16 no's seems like the opposite of a gotcha moment. But the original analysis team was qualified and competent. So how did they see something so different? The answer? Confirmation bias. Our tendency to search for or interpret new information in a way that supports what we already believe. You see, the one difference between the original analysts and the new ones was what they thought was true. The original team knew that there was incriminating testimony. They knew that without a DNA match, the accused could go free. The new analysts didn't, so they were looking at the data with untainted eyes. And while DNA analyses are basically error-proof when it comes to single samples, when it comes to DNA mixtures, there's a lot more ambiguity. Is that really an allele or just a blip in the data? Is there really enough information to make a conclusion? Or is the sample too degraded or complex to even try?
The blood and DNA tests came back inconclusive.
These are the kinds of decision points where bias can come in, even in honest people who are trying to be accurate. Confirmation biases can affect all of us. And what makes them so hard to outsmart is that we think we're finding data that proves us right. For instance, let's say you just know that a colleague didn't deserve that promotion. You see him make a little mistake, and aha, proof, right? Even if it's a slip you would have forgiven in anyone else. What's more, researchers at SUNY Stony Brook University found that when our opinions are challenged, for instance, if you have to read both sides of a debate about gun control or affirmative action, our original beliefs only get stronger after we hear the opposite view. This is bizarre. And it happens because we pick and choose. We focus on the strengths of the arguments we like and the flaws of the arguments we don't. And that leaves us feeling even more firm in our convictions. There are so many ways the confirmation bias can affect us. Maybe you want to invest in a new business venture, and that's making you downplay the risks. Maybe you're completely smitten by a new crush, so you miss seeing all the red flags. All this tells us that if we want to outsmart our minds, we have to learn how to switch from confirming an idea to proving it. Here's a few tips. The desire to confirm can give us tunnel vision, but hindsight is 20/20, so get used to conducting pre-mortems. That is, imagine that the unthinkable has happened.
Breaking headlines.
The company did go under.
Filing for bankruptcy.
The relationship did implode.
The two reportedly broke up.
What killed it? What signs did you miss? Working backwards like this pushes you to find the clues that fell into your blind spot. Another solution for the hypochondriacs among us. Rethink what you're typing into that search bar. Do I have cancer is only going to confirm your worst fears, not give you the most likely answers. Instead, plug in your symptoms, or better yet, consult a professional. Finally, reframe your goals. Don't make half-hearted pro-con lists that only tell you what you want to hear, whether it's a personal decision or an analysis for a Supreme Court case. Make sure everyone knows success means making the best decision, and not just the one you think is right. Outsmarting Human Minds is a project founded by Mahzarin Banaji, devoted to improving decision-making using insights from psychological science. The OHM team includes Olivia Kang, Evan Younger, Kirsten Morehouse, and Mahzarin Banaji. Research assistants include Moshe Poliak and Megan Burns. Music by Miracles of Modern Science. Support for Outsmarting Human Minds comes from Harvard University, PwC, and Johnson & Johnson. For references and related materials, visit outsmartinghumanminds.org.